Frederica Wilson attacks General Kelly's patriotism, Trump's nasty surprise shuts her down. Once again, glittery Representative Frederica Wilson grabbed national headlines by attacking General John Kelly. Wilson got her 15 minutes of fame weeks ago, but she refuses to go away. Every couple of days, she uses social media to attack Kelly's character and his patriotism, but this time, President Donald Trump's nasty surprise for Wilson shut her down for good. You don't want to miss what finally shut the mouth of the rodeo clown who was slandering an American hero. Florida Congresswoman Frederica Wilson thought she had struck gold when she lied about the sympathy call that President Trump made to a military widow. Wilson was looking to get herself national headlines, and she did, but that was a month ago. General John Kelly was so utterly disgusted by her lies, the Marine general spent 2 hours pondering what to do in Arlington Cemetery. Finally, Kelly decided that he couldn't let Wilson's lie stand. He is not one for the limelight, but he powered through a press conference, giving an emotional statement that left many Americans in tears. Kelly was present for the phone call in question. In fact, Trump had specifically asked Kelly, the seasoned military man, what would be appropriate to say in such a difficult call. Kelly reminded the press that Wilson was nothing but an empty barrel, a term that Wacky Wilson screamed was racist. Plato wrote about empty barrels or empty vessels, as Forbes points out Plato's famous quote, "An empty vessel makes the loudest sound, so they that have the least wit are the greatest babblers." Poor bedazzled Frederica got caught in another lie. Empty barrels have nothing to do with race. But, that was nothing compared to Wilson's continued attacks on Kelly. Every time she tweets, it's to bash General Kelly, a real American hero. General Kelly owes the nation an apology. "When he lied about me, he lied to the American public," tweeted Wilson on November 18. Fox News reports, Representative Frederica Wilson has reignited a weeks-old feud with White House Chief of Staff John Kelly, saying he should apologize to the nation for false claims she says he made about her speech at a federal building ceremony. All the major news networks are giving Rhinestone Cowgirl coverage, and Kelly is too much of an officer and a gentleman to get into a Twitter war over himself. Just as Kelly came to Trump's defense when he was overwrought by the Florida congresswoman's lies, Trump decided to shut Wilson down with a nasty surprise. Trump gave her a nickname that has stuck from weeks ago, and it's pissing her off. He tweeted, "The fake news is going crazy with wacky Congresswoman Wilson D, who is secretly on a very personal call," and gave a total lie on content. Now, he hit Hillary Clinton with a tweet, and Trump supporters tacked wacky Wilson's name to it, and it's going viral. Trump calls Hillary biggest loser of all time in a most excellent tweet. "At real Donald Trump, she is the best thing to happen to Republicans in a long time." Well, along with Al Franken, Nancy Pelosi, Frederica Wilson, Joe Biden, Maxine Waters. Tweeted a main author. Wilson's tacky rhinestone cowgirl getup just got a female deputy sheriff in a lot of trouble, and we think this story is as ridiculous as wacky Wilson looks. Deputy sheriff under fire for blackface Frederica Wilson Halloween costume because whiteness might be a mental illness, reports The Root. The article says the NAACP has filed an official complaint against Deputy Jean Browning, who works for the York Bokeson Sheriff's Department in Virginia, over wearing blackface as part of her costume as Frederica. Her boyfriend went dressed as Trump. After the local NAACP agreed that it was offensive and wanted her fired immediately, her boss, the sheriff, didn't agree. The Root, a leftist pro-Black Lives Matter site, reported, York Bokeson Sheriff J.D. Diggs didn't agree. He held a press conference. He did not fire Deputy Browning. He did not even suspend Browning. He reassigned her. Browning will no longer be working with the school system. Browning was reassigned to the court system. It's time to push back on some of the nonsense claiming that everything is racist. Wearing blackface can be racist, but I did not find Jean Browning's costume racist. Fox News Laura Ingraham agreed and mentioned leading up to Halloween that she wanted a Frederica bedazzled hat, but costume stores were sold out. Not everything is racist. Calling the Florida congresswoman wacky Wilson or an empty barrel isn't. she doesn't get a free pass on criticism because of skin color. And, Jean Browning's costume is making fun of Frederica, which is not against the law, nor is it a hate crime. Frederica Wilson and her Black Lives Matter rhetoric have elevated her to the ranks of Maxine Waters and Nancy Pelosi, that is about as infamous as she will ever get.